We have people working on this building.
Just drug driving in.
I mean, I work on this building till 4 o'clock in the morning. Then they can get off work. I get off work about double. I get done in 30 minutes on the last off. I'm home. I've been here working on this building, painting the wall, getting it ready. That reminds me so much. You know what? 18 years, this being 19, I'm still working on this building. But we, I've had a lot of people that's come through the church. A lot of people, I mean, we've had paint battles in here. You wouldn't believe it. You wouldn't believe it. We get here, we get rolled in the paint. Somebody looked at me wrong, I'd paint them. I'm glad it relates that. But we just had a lot of fun here working on this building. My boss family here seen us doing that when I worked with him. He fired me. But we worked on this building a lot of times, a lot of nights I worked on it. And I walked on the front porch, the Lord said, right here is where I want you to build my church. When you walk upon the porch and you feel the Holy Ghost, you better obey God. You better obey God. You know, every time you turn around, somebody thinks, well, I don't know if I'm going to listen to that preacher, but he can't be still. Hello?
Amen.
Or he preaches too long.
Amen. That's okay.
I mean, I'm like, yeah, you give me 5 minutes, I'm going to take 30. You know, that's just the way it is. When God tells me to shut up, hey, I'm going to shut up. But it's going to have to be God to do it. Not somebody going to go home and get a hamburger. I made a mistake one time. I laid out of church, went fishing. Blowed up a bass boat. 3 or 4 of my rod reels I lost. I guarantee you one if I ain't been fishing on Sunday no more like that. But see, a lot of times, we say, well, I just don't feel like going today. I've been ever done that.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, I just don't feel like going to church today. I think I'm going to stay home. I guarantee you better come on to church. But you might be missing out on something. I remember when they first operated on gas, staple from here all the way up. I come here with that wheelchair and I preached anyway. Come on now. You know what? I didn't have big pain. Not a bit. I have been standing here, couldn't even hardly walk. But guess what? I still preached. But you know, when the Holy Ghost gets a hold of you and gets to moving, you ain't going to feel no pain. You ain't going to feel no sorrow. You ain't going to think about what's on the outside of this place. You want to think about who's in here and who's ready to meet Jesus. I could care less about what your past is. I could write a book about me. Probably number one seller. But see, we got a problem bringing our past up and forgetting about the future. We spend more time giving the devil more credit about where we used to be than what we're doing right now.
That's right.
That's what we do.
That's right. Yep.
I ain't giving you nothing. Brother Jerry, he had me for a long time. He ain't getting me in. When I knelt down on that altar, I give it all to Jesus. And guess what? The devil's mad and I'm glad.
I'm going to say, why preach? Uh-oh. There it is. That thing where I live my feet.